thank you. So today I'm going to be talking about to you about high temperature graphene sensors for harsh environment current sensing. So firstly, I'm just going to briefly talk about the motivation behind the project and why we decided to use graphene, some of the main applications, and the key results we have so far, and how we're going to develop the work further in the future. So the main motivation behind the project is to provide Hall sensors that are capable of monitoring current flow through power electronic converters, with the main application for this being within the aerospace industry, so in aircraft engines. As such, this requires the device characteristics to be stable at both high temperature and also high frequencies for the electronic converters. So, present semiconducting Hall sensors typically suffer from thermal instability if high temperatures due to band gap narrowing, and this increases your intrinsic carrier density, so it means your output from your sensors becomes unusable at the temperature range we're looking at. Current technology is also limited to frequencies of less than 120 kHz, so this kind of precludes its use in power electronic converters at present. So this brings us on to why we're interested in using graphene. I think a lot of graphene's properties have been well reported in the past 10 years or so. Everyone seems to be very excited by it. It's got high carrier mobility, high thermal conductivity, and a very low carrier density. The low carrier density is of particular interest to us, as if you can see from the equation in the top right, that is the output of a Hall sensor. So the lower your carrier density, the higher your Hall output. So already these properties lead to improved device sensitivity over existing technologies. The main interest though is that graphene is a zero band gap material. So if we see from the figure in the bottom right hand corner, the conduction and valence bands meet and the Fermi level sits at this point in pristine graphene. In practical devices, the Fermi level is shifted due to doping or strain in the graphene surface, but you can shift the Fermi level back to the Dirac point through external gate biasing. Another advantage of graphene is that the synthesis techniques have developed a lot since the mechanical exfoliation, and of particular interest to us, you can grow it epitaxially in silicon carbide, which again allows for use in high temperature applications. So, the main purpose of the talk is to talk about the high temperature properties of the graphene itself. So, as I said previously, the semiconductor materials that they typically use for Hall sensors, indium and antimonide is the most popular one. The band gap narrows with increasing temperature, so you get an increase in intrinsic carrier density. This isn't an issue in graphene, so you remove a large amount of the thermal instability. So the image on the right is an example of someone's actually tried to design a graphene temperature sensor. They're kind of interested in the opposite of what I'm interested in. They want it to be sensitive to temperature. However, they found pretty much the opposite. So if you look at the graph a bit closer, it shows carrier density is a function of gate bias with increasing temperature. And the area of interest to us is you can see that actually at a gate bias of 3 volts, the thermal coefficient is reduced, it's almost negligible. So if you can tune where the Fermi level is in your graphene, you can actually reduce the thermal instability in your device. So the main applications, as I said, for this is the one we're most interested in is in power electronic converters, but it can also be used in a position sensor. So you can, instead of detecting the current, you can detect the magnetic field. And you just use the strength of the magnetic field to determine the distance from the Hall plate. And this gives you both positional information, and you can also use it to infer the speed of the motor. So just a little quick background on Hall effect sensor itself before I move on to the results. So essentially, the Hall effect is you just you apply a current to opposing nodes on a conductive material, place it within a magnetic field, and that generates a voltage perpendicular to the direction of current flow. So this means you can use it as either a current sensor or a magnetic sensor, depending on what your unknown is. Typically, this Hall output is quite low level, so you need an amplification stage to be able to use your output signal. So the figure 9 on the right just shows the Hall system as a whole. So the graphene sensors we've fabricated in this project so far, they were fabricated on CVD graphene on a silicon oxide substrate. So we initially fabricated devices on silicon as just a sort of proof of concept device, because silicon carbide itself is quite expensive to manufacture and purchase. So the image on the left just shows is a diagram of the Hall structures we use. So there's two types of Hall structures, just your basic four terminal one, or we also have an eight terminal device, which just gives you a more output and a more accurate reading. The results in the top right is an example of your sort of typical output and how you would determine the performance of a Hall sensor. So you have the Hall resistance as a function of magnetic field, and from the gradient of this graph, you can the gradient of the graph is your current related sensitivity, so that's how sensitive your device is to the magnetic field or the current, and you can also extract critical electronic properties such as the carrier density and mobility from this. So in order to determine how the electronic properties of the graphic